Welcome to CineCurious. My name is Laura and this is
Nathan.
Nathan, hi. Today we watch your favorite show in the world, Heartstopper. I have to be honest, I never heard of it before. I never watched it. Mm-hmm. I never saw a trailer. I don't know who's in it, but I know that one actor is in the 60th anniversary special of Doctor Who. And I know her. I know is that she's involved.
Yes,
but any other actor, anything else from the cast, I know nothing. I don't know what it's about. So please tell me, what am I involved?
There is another actor in Agatha All Along called Joe Locke as well. He's in that.
Show me. So, show me during that because I don't even know the name.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Heartstopper, I have seen both series 1 and 2. I have not seen series 3, which has just dropped.
Mm-hmm.
So that'll be interesting. The way I describe the show is like a warm hug. It's positive representation for LGBT folk and realistic stories, which, unlike other LGBT shows, have had extreme drama, trauma, etc. And this is kind of one of a kind in the sense that it's positive representation and the show I wish I had when I was growing up.
Oh, true. That's a good thing. Also, representation-wise, I mean, it's not Call Me By Your Name, right? Where you have two straight guys trying to play gays.
No.
That's good. Because
out of the actors that have come out, they represent their respective where they are, their respective letter, shall we say. But obviously some of them haven't come out and we shouldn't speculate on that. That's their private life,
obviously. But, you know, if you don't know anything, don't know anything, and you don't want to judge, but mm-hmm. there are too many, what I'm saying is there are too many film series where LGBTQIA people are represented by openly straight people who are not in that community and do not necessarily know struggle experience or just day-to-day business of these people.
Exactly.
That is what I'm talking
and this,
about.
This show shows the entire works, and it is technically in the teen
mm-hmm.
genre section, but I think it's just as valuable for adults to watch of all ages.
I'm looking forward to that.
It's really nice, and it gives you a really nice feeling.
Lovely.
When you watch it. That's how I feel about it anyway.
Lovely. It's my third sip of water, so maybe we should just start. I cannot wait to see it now. Thank you for the suggestion, and we go now.
You can already tell already, this is adapted from a graphic novel, if you're wondering.
Yeah, I was wondering why the cartoonish look. Hi, Ben Hope. Can't wait to see you too. Which is weird, because I think it's a child. I shouldn't say that.
Ben?
Do you know who the voice that is?
I know that voice. I was just wondering, who is it?
Stephen Fry.
Enjoy getting to know some fresh faces in registration.
I love Stephen Fry.
Let's see, where did I put you on this seating plan?
Ah, yes.
You're over there, next to Nicholas Nelson. He's in year 11.
Okay, that's a nice teacher.
One of the rugby boys, too.
Yeah.
I'm sure you'll get along swimmingly.
But didn't we all have those at school?
Yeah. Oh, look at them!
Hi. Hi.
I love that! So happy! And we all know that feeling.
high school crushes.
Oh yeah, the worst.
Hey. Sorry about earlier.
It's fine.
I miss your face so much.
Did you have a good Christmas?
Oh, he's reacting like they are not used to kissing each other.
Still don't tell anyone about this.
Oh.
Did you see that? Wipe it away.
Why?
I don't understand. I thought they might be a thing, but was that a very weird first kiss?
That was a kiss.
It was a kiss, but we do not know right now. Oh, hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. You going that way?
Yeah, Maths.
Same.
Are you literally... Do you want me to see that for you?
The guy with the black curly hair is egging in Agatha all
the time. Okay.
Oh, yeah, I remember him from the trailer. That's true.
Look. Better?
Aww.
Hey.
What?
What?
Just hi.
Why are you talking to me? I don't even know who you are.
Ugh.
I see where we are here.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah. What are your thoughts?
My thoughts are,
your friends are Ben.
Yeah.
He at least doesn't want people to know that they know each other in the kissy-kissy sense. I don't know where that's coming from his side. What his motives are, but obviously it's the typical I don't know you, but when we're alone I know you.
I bought Elle's drink again.
Didn't you do that yesterday as well?
Yes, Isaac.
She's not here.
I know.
She's not been here a week.
I know, I just keep forgetting.
How you're allowed to miss her.
Okay.
So Elle's not there. And this is a
yeah, Mystery's a massive transphobe.
It's still weird, though. There used to be four of us, and now there's only three. Like, four is a group.
So, is Elle the dead name? Did I get that right?
Elle is her chosen name.
Chosen name, okay.
Charlie, you don't have a tissue, do you?
That dude and his ink.
Just, exploded.
Did your pen ever explode in school?
No, of course not.
Careful.
What? Why?
Why? Look at them. Look at us. We are a trio of borderline outcasts. He is the star player on the rugby team, and he's friends with a bunch of loud, gross year 11s who are exactly like the guys who bullied you last year.
Huh. But like, Nick, he's different. He's nice.
I bet he's a whole different person when he's with his
what do you think of his hair?
Dude friends.
Honestly, I know where it's coming from. It's happening when you put it behind your ear, but no. L. I got L, as in L Bundy. Okay. L.
Yasmin Finney.
Ha. Okay, now I know. Why did she change schools? Should I not know now? Oh no.
We don't make exceptions even for new students. You can have this back from reception at the end of the day.
It's an all-boys school and an all-girls school, and after transitioning...
Yes.
Okay, now I get it. In Germany, we don't really have, like, that... boys school, girls school thing, but that is another level. Imagine going through that process and then you have to switch schools completely. It is.
Yeah, and now she doesn't have her phone either, so she can't even talk to her old friends. Is he going to stand him up again?
I hope he's standing him up.
Oh no, he's there.
You know, I'm sorry about ignoring you yesterday.
Are you though? No. As a teenager, you never really understand that this is toxic, right?
It's quite a while since you've hidden in here at lunch.
I'm not hiding.
Then what are you doing?
Eating lunch.
Oh, right. So everything's okay? There's no bullies I need to sort out again?
No, everything's fine. I've got a boyfriend.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Clap, clap, clap. Applause, applause.
Clap, 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 clap.
I don't even know if... I don't think he even thinks we're boyfriends anyway. He ignores me sometimes. He doesn't even like people seeing us talk to each other in the corridors.
That's not a boyfriend.
He pretends like he doesn't know who I am.
No. Dude, listen to yourself.
But then when it's just us two, he's fine.
Well, have you talked to him about how that makes you feel?
Instead of me right now in my lunch break?
Talk to him then? What do you want me to say? Break up with him?
Don't know.
Do you want to break up with him?
I love Mr. Ajayi, though, because he's giving him a safe space.
Better to be honest about your feelings in the long run.
I hate being honest.
Life lessons.
It took
life lessons.
3 months to tell me you were being bullied.
They'll like you. Okay.
I really don't like Ben, by the way. I didn't from the jump when I first watched this.
What's his name, the protagonist? Like, in serious?
Charlie.
Alright. Don't. That is never the answer. But gosh, I know those situations. That was a good answer. I don't know how old he's supposed to be. 16, 17? Yeah.
He's in year 10, I believe he's 15.
Okay, 15
right now.
Looks a bit too old, but that's that. Don't ignore me. I mean, he just told him no. Blah.
Morning.
Jesus, Tori.
Why's your face like that?
Break up with my boyfriend.
Was he a knob?
Yes.
Yes.
Well done then.
I mean, good view on that.
Hypothetically, what sort of boy do you want to go out with?
One who doesn't mind people seeing us talk to each other would be nice.
Someone who's also a nerd, or do you want like an opposites attract thing?
Just someone I can have a laugh with. And he's nice and kind. And likes being with me.
Funny, nice, kind, likes him. That's low standard.
Mm-hmm.
That is low standard.
That's the bare minimum.
Isn't it? I mean, how about manners?
Oh, that classic trope.
Uh-huh. Let me help you pick that up.
So, I had something I wanted to ask you. Charlie, I wanted to tell you that I'm gay too. And
oh,
I'm
he
in love
is
with
envisioning.
You.
This is a dream.
Do you want to go out with me?
Yeah, this is
a dream.
I
want to
be with you forever. Do you want to join the rugby team?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
We have enough players for the team.
Let's
but
do that.
You're not allowed to actually play against other teams without a reserve. And, you know, I saw you run in PE and you're, like, really fast. So, I thought you might be interested.
That was all I was ever good at in PE, was because I'm tall, was running. Look.
I played basketball because I'm tall too.
Weak to be a rugby player?
Mm-hmm.
We're just a school team, you know. It's not.
And you're sure you want to spend a whole hour with giant moronic rugby lads?
Yes.
I mean. I mean.
I know I was joking about being weak, but I'm definitely too weak for this.
Where is your can-do attitude?
Oh, she left long ago.
Just try, tackle me, I won't dodge.
Come on, I bet you can do it.
Let's
go on.
Tackle.
That was perfect.
Was it?
Was it?
Yeah. Now, let's try again while I'm actually moving.
Oh,
come on.
Oh. I don't know rugby, I'm sorry. I thought you were supposed to do that.
You are, but when they're
okay.
Moving.
I thought you should just ran into everyone. You know,
it was just a practice.
He knows how to do this now. I think we should learn.
I mean, to give you enough of the rules for this, you can only pass backwards, you can't pass forwards, and you are allowed to kick the ball. If it goes over the top, you get more points, or you can run across the field and put it on the floor over the line.
I forgot all of that already, but thank you.
But you can't pass it forwards, as we back behind you. And people can tackle you if you have the ball in your hand. I think that's enough context. Oh, bless Elle.
I mean, they could have said hello.
She didn't have her phone, did she? So they probably couldn't, like, arrange to meet.
But they were seeing each other, I don't know, on the street.
Did they see each other? I thought that they hadn't. There's those graphic novel. I love all the little graphic novel-y bits that they throw in.
I like them too. For the moment. I don't know where it's going with them, you know? Because one example is Ms. Marvel, where, in my opinion, they overdid it. I don't know if you've seen it, but I thought it was too much.
I haven't.
And here, I love the little tiny bits and pieces, but it should stay there for me to focus on what they are actually showing. But that's my first impression right now.
Just gonna go meet Ben.
I didn't read it. What did it say?
Meet me after the rugby, I think. And he said, fine, Mac.
Bye.
And Nick saw him walk off.
Charlie. You're wearing a coat. It's not even cold.
Time for a tackle, if you ask me.
Elaine.
What do you want, Ben?
Exactly.
Don't touch me.
God, what's your problem? I'm trying to be nice.
I said I don't want to meet up with you anymore.
Yeah, and I don't believe you.
What?
You're clearly just scared of getting caught.
Why would I be scared of getting caught? Everyone in school already knows I'm gay. You're the one who's scared of getting caught. You can't even look at me when other people are around.
Yeah, good for
Not
you.
Not to mention the fact that you have a girlfriend. Yeah, I've seen you with her at the school gate. Thanks for telling me. I'm angry because you never even slightly cared about my feelings. We'll never meet up when you want to, where you want to, when you feel like kissing a boy. You don't care about me at all.
Well, it's not like anyone else is going to want to go out with you, is it?
Lashing out immediately.
Oh,
I don't like this bit.
I know you like me.
Stop it! Charlie, look, I like you, but I'm figuring stuff out. Literally, what more do you want from me?
No. Oh, it's rugby, dude.
I told you to stop.
See you, Ben. See you.
Piss off.
Piss off, Ben.
Piss off, Ben.
Hug him. Hug him. He needs a hug.
Yeah.
Did you hear all of that? Most of it.
I just... You seemed kind of like something was up while we were getting changed, so I wanted to check everything was okay.
So nice. Sorry.
So nice.
You have nothing to be sorry about.
Sorry.
You say sorry a lot. Don't say it.
I kind of want to say it.
Don't.
Still in that rugby boy mode. Bro.
I mean, they are literally going out together out of the building. Does it count?
Sorry. No, no way. Okay. Bye.
Bye.
But they live opposite directions.
Hmm. And he's always looking back. Yeah. He's happy. He's happy. I mean, he was almost mouth raped a minute before, but now he's happy.
Yeah, that's SA. Very sad. Nick's mum's played by Olivia Colman. I don't know if you caught that.
Nick?
What? Yeah, it was normal.
Aww.
That's all he needs to say. With an X.
Oh, and now he's seeing the little birdie birds.
Oh. Yes.
That was Heartstopper, first episode. I can only say, Nathan, thank you for showing that to me. I'm a fangirl already. I'm an instant fan. I'm shipping everyone in this. I love the characters. I love the cast. I love everything. Amazing.
I was going to follow. My first question was, what are your initial thoughts? You know, any predictions?
Oh, predictions. I mean, the only thing I have to say is that everybody involved is behaving very grown up, I would say.
Yes.
I was not as grown up when I was 15.
No, not at all.
I would have sent all the first messages he typed out.
Yeah, yeah.
That would have been me. And I did not have a, let's say, happy relationship during that time. So maybe that is the point there. That is the only thing I thought from my perspective as a now almost 25 years older than they are portraying. I have to say, this is how I would react these days. This is a very grown up level.
And this leads into something I wanted to say about how I wish I had this show when I was growing up, being LGBT myself, because it shows positive communication.
Yes.
There is slight drama. There was that one scene that was a little bit uncomfortable to watch, but wasn't, I mean, we could talk about that. It was very clear what it was and what it was representing.
Yeah.
I remember when I first watched this, I didn't like Ben from the very beginning. There was just something off straight away.
Yeah. I mean, it's always the telltale when you have to meet somewhere in the corner, somewhere. And then they didn't take too much time. I like that. You didn't have to wait much to find that out, because I think it was a minute later that the hallway scene was where he was like, I don't even know you. I love that from a pacing perspective, that the whole setting is very clear from the beginning on. Nicky is his name, the rugby guy.
Nick.
His mom called him Nicky. I'm not his mom.
That's his little nickname, I guess. Nickname Nick.
Okay, so Nick. I do think he is interesting, but we don't know, because we come from Charlie's perspective right now. We don't know too much about him yet. So we are figuring that out alongside Charlie. I love their cute little hi, hello things.
Hi.
And they dragged that out throughout the whole episode, and I love they came back to that later. It is a very strong first episode. You were not promising too much.
Thoughts on Elle? How they handled that?
Yeah, I mean, we were talking about it during the stream. I think, from a German perspective, there are schools in Germany where you have all boys, all girls schools, but they are so rare. I mean,
same here. I think they did that on purpose to show not tell about L, if that makes sense.
No, but they were telling right from the start. I just didn't hear the name correctly.
Because Tao said that there was a teacher that refused to call her L, wasn't there?
Yeah, something like that. within the whole discussion about we are not a group anymore, we were four and now we're just three, and then they mentioned it, and I just got the name wrong. I thought it was A-L-L. I didn't hear the French L, so that's why I was thinking, L, is that the dead name? Because I thought it was L, but it was L, and that's a beautiful name. So coming back to that, I went to a very strict Catholic school myself. So I was, we were praying hard. But I was the fourth grade after they let in boys. So I'm the fourth class after they allowed boys in. So I never had that experience, but at least a strict school, but no uniforms, by the way. This is something I'm always a bit jealous of, to be honest. Did you have a school uniform?
Yep. Pretty much all state-owned schools in the UK wear uniform.
From time to time, I would have loved it because it takes a lot of pressure off what to wear to school.
And there is pros and cons. The idea is, I think, in the UK that they want to reduce bullying because people perhaps who are of a lower social class perhaps cannot afford specific designer wear, etc. They want to make everyone more uniform and present the same to prevent bullying. But then again, these uniforms, when I started school, started to go up and up in price. So then you started getting people coming in hand-me-downs. So the thing that they have been trying to prevent, well, it's still happening anyway. And people wear their uniform differently. Some people have their shirts untucked, even though it was against the rules. Things like that. You can still stylize it. So
I see.
But that's the idea. That's what the UK were trying to do, or England or Wales. I can only speak for England, but that was the idea, to stop bullying based on.
I mean, I was, from my perspective, it was more about I was the punk rock chick. I mean, I was 15 when Avril Lavigne came up, all of that, right? So, was I? Let's go with it. I'm not counting now. But you know the style, the coming out of the 90s, the Offspring, and then going into the 2000s where you just made pop punk somewhat fashionable. And that was me. And as I said, the very good Christian school where everyone else was more like collar up and everything. So that was the people around me. And then I came in with my leather belts and everything. So that was different. Sometimes I would have loved to just not iron my uniform and be punk in that sense. But yeah, it is what it is. Okay. Do you want me to give you any predictions to what is happening next in Heartstopper?
Yes. Why not? You can guess tonally how the show is, I think already.
Yeah.
So you can kind of, there is a goalpost for how far it could potentially go. It's up to you how far you think it, you just explain your predictions for me, what you think might happen.
I'm thinking. I was talking too quick because I don't have any right now. Let me think. Nick and Charlie are cute together. I love them. I want them to become something. But it would take a long, long time for them to figure something out for themselves because we do not even know what Nick is into, to be honest. So will they, won't they, will be a thing. And it will be during all of season one at least, what I'm thinking. Might be that the whole group thing, the friendship circle, was already introduced as having a problem now, as not being whole anymore. So what's Curly Hair's name? The one that he Bob? Tao?
T-A-O, Tao.
Ah, Tao, okay. I think there will be a rift of some kind in that friendship group. They were not happy about Charlie being a rugby player now. Maybe even going so far as, Charlie, are you changing yourself to fit into a new group? Something like that could happen. At some point, because we are in a school, I would love to see school. I want to see them in class at some point.
Right.
Honestly. And apart from that, yeah, L. Lovely L. What are we doing with L? Because there has to be a story arc too. She's an amazing actor. I want to see her in a far, far beyond story arc to really get into what it means for her right now to not only finding herself in a new personality. No, that's wrong. Finding her identity in a new body. Maybe we should put it like that. There is a lot to change. And
also moving schools is hard enough, let alone...
Right, but at the same time, getting used to your new appearance like that. And we don't know her backstory. We don't know what happened before or where she's coming from in experience. Mm-hmm. But there has to be a big change. There had to be a big change just before, because Tao was saying, now we are on equal. So she must have just changed schools. So probably her official identity has just changed. That's what I'm thinking. And that is, in a series like that, where you have such good opinions from people, the writing is really good so far. And I want is exactly these writers to follow Elle on her journey and let us be part of it. Yeah. Okay, that's enough predictions, right? Don't tell me if I was right. I don't want to.
I'm saying
know.
Nothing.
Okay.
I'm really glad you liked it.
It's always cool when someone else likes your favorite show. That's true. And now we have to be very honest to our dear lovely viewers. We will right away watch another one, right?
Yes, we're going to go now watch another one.
Yeah. So right now we say thank you and goodbye. Please like us and please subscribe to us.
Yes.
We need it. And then we will see you in the next video right away. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.